Hello friends, welcome to Input Output Campus, and today we'll discuss about a new coding question, which is shuffle the array. So the question is given the array nums consisting of 2n elements in the form x1 to xn and y1 to yn. Return the array in the form x1 y1 x2 y2 dot 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 xn yn. So you are given an array nums of size 2n. So what is the value of n? So the value of n is 3 and the size of the array is 2n, that is 6. So here in the array, the first element is x1, then x2 and then x3, and then this is y1 and then y2 and y3. So you have to return x1 and y1 first, that is you have to return 2 and then 3 and then 5 and then 4 and then 1 and then 7. Here 2 is the x1 and 3 is the, this 3 is the y1, and this 5 is the x2, this 5 is the x2, and this 4 is the y2. Okay, and this 1 is the x3 and this 7 is the y3. So this will be your output array and you have to return this array as output. Okay, so this is very easy type question. So before going to solution, please try to solve this question by your own, and after that please watch the solution. So let's solve it using C++. So first of all, write the basic format of the C++, that is as include bits / standard C++.h using namespace standard. First write the main function here. And inside the main function, we'll write a vector where we'll store all these elements. Okay, we'll store all these elements and this n also. So write here a vector and its data type will be integer because we want to store the integer values. Okay, and the name of the vector is nums and it contains the elements, these elements. So let's copy these elements from here and paste it here. Okay, so next will be an integer variable n and the value is 3. Now we'll write a function. So the name of the function is shuffle array, and inside this we'll pass this nums and n. So before this main function, we'll write the same function again and it will return an array. So here you can see it return an array. So we have to return an integer type array. So here we have used vector, so we'll return vector from here. So write here vector, and the type of the vector is integer because it contains integer values. Okay, so next write the function, that is shuffle array, and then write the vector and its data type is integer, and then the name of the vector. Okay, and then integer n. So first of all, we'll write a vector here where we'll store all the result. Okay, so for that write here a vector, and this is integer type vector, and the name of the vector is result. Now we'll write a for loop to iterate this num vector. Okay, so write a for loop here. So for int I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. So using this for loop and this n, so the value of n is 3. So for I equals to 0, that is for the first iteration, we'll store this 2 and then 3. And then for the second iteration, that is when I will be 1, then we'll store 5 and 4. Next, for the I equals to 2, that is the third iteration, we'll store 1 and 7. Okay, and we'll store all the results into this result vector. So how to do this? So we want to store the first element, that is I equals to 0. This element is n plus I, so our n value is 3 and I value is 0. So initial I value is 0, so 3 plus 0, which is 3. So here you can see 0 1 2 3. So this is the index 3 and the element is also 3. So we'll push back to result nums of I. That is the first element of the vector will be pushed back to this result vector, and the n plus I element. So n plus I element is this element. So n plus I element will also be pushed back to the result. Okay. For that, write here result dot push back nums of n plus I. Okay. So in this way, we can store all the results, and finally we'll return the result because all the results are stored into this result vector. So we'll return the result from here. So as the result is a vector, so here the return type is vector. Okay, so we'll store the returned vector into a vector. So write here vector and its type is integer, and then suppose the name of the vector is answer. I will store all the results. So now we want to print all the elements. So for that, write here for int I equals to answer dot begin, I not equals to answer dot end, and then I plus plus, and then print all the elements, that is asterisk I. So this will print all the elements. So after printing every element, give a space here. Okay, so our code is complete and let's run it. Okay, so there is an error in line number 19. So write here auto. Okay, and run it again. Okay, so here you can see the output is 235417, and our expected output was 235417. Okay, so the output is perfect. So this is a easy type question, and hope these types of question and the concepts will be helpful for your upcoming coding test. So exactly this question may not be asked in your upcoming examination, but the concept is the main thing. So you have to grab all the concepts. So that's the main thing. So hope you enjoyed this video, and if you find this video helpful, then please like the video and share it with your friends. So thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video. Till then, take care.